Hi there. In this video, we will see what are the steps that are required to install Talend. Talend is an ETL tool. It is open source and there is a free version available, which means you can download it today and start building your ETL projects. So let's start with the prerequisite. The prerequisite for installing Talend is JDK latest version. So let's start downloading the JDK first. I'm just going to Google for JDK download. I'll click on the very first link available. Not to worry, I'll be posting this link in the description as well of this YouTube video. Now, in the JDK download page, the latest version available as of 15th of August 2018 is Java 10. But I'm going to skip that and probably download the previous version, which is Java SE 8U181. All right, so here is the link, JDK. It takes me to the next page where I'll have to say accept. Now here again, there are two separate categories links. So you have development kit 8U181 and you have development kit 8U181 demos and samples. So we'll just stick with the first one. Here, make sure you select the right link based on the operating system. For example, I'm using Windows 64-bit, which means I'll be selecting the very last link here. In case you're using Windows 32-bit, you must use the link that's above the 64-bit. Or if it's Linux or Mac, you have all the other links here. Now, if you're on Windows, how do you find out whether your computer is 64-bit or 32-bit? You can do that by right-clicking on this PC, go to Properties, and here you can see if it's 32-bit or 64-bit. All right, so let me start downloading the 64-bit. Now this is 203 MB. It will take a couple of minutes. So let's wait for it and we'll start downloading Talend as well. So I'll open another tab and search for Talend download. Again, you can find the link for this in the description of this video. All right, so I'm in the download page. Now, this page keeps, changing very often, but you should be able to find it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to scroll down. You'll see for some links like try now. So when anytime there is a try now, it usually means it's a trial version. It's not the free version, right? So you keep scrolling down and then you see this section, try these free products. Again, under that, there are a lot of products, but the one that we need is data integration. So I'm going to click on download free tool. Okay, so it took me to the next page, but the download is yet to start. So I'll give it a few seconds. Okay, nothing happened so far. This is quite common. So I'll click on the download button. All right, there you go. So the download has just started. It is around 1 GB. So let me forward this video to a position where everything is installed and ready. All right, so it took a couple of minutes, around 5-6 minutes for the Talend to download completely. It really depends on the internet connection you have, but it's finally done. Now, first thing I want to do is I want to install the JDK. So let me open the exe file. And while we install the JDK, you'll see that from the download page of Talend, you can sign up and you can download a free user guide. So, you know, go ahead and do that if you want to. So I'll click on next to install JDK. There is a good chance that your machine already has the latest JDK. So even then, if you were to run the exe file, it'll simply overwrite or it will prompt you that it's already installed. So that shouldn't be a problem. So click on next. Now this should complete under a minute. All right, so it's almost there. All right, I'll click on close. So now we have successfully installed JDK. Now let's begin with Talend. So let me first open the folder where it's downloaded. So as you can see, it went to my downloads folder. Now, before I can unzip the files, I'm first going to rename it. Because the file name is too lengthy, I'll just rename it to, let's say, TOS, which stands for Talend Open Studio. Right click and say extract all. And I'll say extract. It's very important you rename the folder or the file before you extract. Otherwise, what will happen is the folder name will be too lengthy, and when it's trying to extract the files, you know, there is some kind of a limit. So some files may error out saying, you know, you cannot extract it because the file path is simply too long, much longer than what Windows can support. So it's always advisable to rename the file to, you know, just two or three characters. Okay, so you can see it's extracting all the files to a new folder called TOS. So the time that it needs depends on your system resources as well, how much of memory and how much of CPU is left. So in my case, it's a dual core CPU with 10 GB memory. So it should be pretty fast. All right, so I'll skip over to when the extraction is complete. All right, so the extraction is complete, and this is something to observe. So this PC downloads TOS. This is the folder. Under that, there is one more folder called TOS, right? So although we renamed the file name, the .zip file name, there is still a subfolder with this, you know, pretty lengthy name. So what I'm going to do is, if you open up this folder, here are the files. I'm going to select all of these. I'll cut them and put it in the parent folder. All right, so now I don't have to use this folder. It's empty now, so I'll just delete this. Right, so now the path is pretty simple. It just says this PC or C uses the username downloads and TOS. The reason I want to do this is because I want to keep the length of this path as short as possible, right? Because they're pretty lengthy file names within these folders, and you know, you shouldn't come across any issues when accessing them. So that's the reason. So now we are all set with the extraction. The thing to observe here is there is no installation as such, right? You really don't have to install anything. It's just a portable file, which makes it, you know, really nice. You may not need admin rights, right? You may not have admin rights on particular PC. You can still download the zip file. All you have to do is extract it, and assuming that the JDK is already installed, you can start using it. So right now, this is a Windows PC. So you'll see there are a lot of files here, right? A lot of executable files. You'll find one called x86-64, which means this is the file you want to run if you're on Windows. If it is Mac, then you have this file. If it's Linux, you have these other files, right? So I'm going to select the Windows file, which is tosdi-win-x86-64. Right click, open. You will get this warning, just say run. Now the very first time you launch Talend, it may take several minutes. It really depends on your PC, but it will take several minutes. But this is a one-time thing. After the first time, the subsequent executions are much more faster. It will open up really quick. Also, make sure that when you launch Talend, you do have an active internet connection, because it does download some additional libraries. All right, so this is your normal terms and agreement, license agreements. So I'll just click on I accept. I'll say, do you want to create a new project? I'll just say finish. All right, so we are almost there. Now it's just loading all the libraries that come along with these installation files. And this is the part that takes the maximum amount of time on every first run of Talend. Right, and you will see, after the subsequent runs will be much, much faster. So it automatically opened up a URL for Talend with the next steps and so on, and any resources that are useful for using Talend. But I'm just going to close that for now and get back to Talend. Okay, I believe the UI is still loading. It's a little unresponsive. All right, we are all set. Okay, so the first time you install, you get this nice wizard. Welcome to Talend Studio. So you can click on next, 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 and so on, and it will show a couple of things about the editor, so that you get familiar. But I'm just going to click on close, because there's one important step that we need to finish when you install Talend for the very first time. All right, so it just opened up a demo job. Let's forget about it, but look at the bottom right side of the Talend window. You see, check for extra features, right? It shows 50%. Now, don't start working unless this is complete. Okay, so let's see what's happening here. Now you need to wait for this to complete. It may take a couple of minutes. So what it's doing is that when you initially download Talend, it does come with some libraries, but it needs other libraries as well. But these other libraries have an agreement. You need to accept the agreement, right? The license agreement. Of course, they're free of cost. You don't have to pay anything, right? But it requires you to manually confirm that yes, you accept, and only then it will start downloading them. So right now, it's collecting all that information and it will present to you on a screen. Okay, so let's just give it a few minutes. All right, so the check took around 2 to 3 minutes. Once it's done, it presents you with this window. Choose the features to install for additional Talend packages. In that, you'll see two categories, required third-party libraries and optional. There are 46 required third-party libraries. Right? These have to be installed. Otherwise, there are many things that wouldn't work. Optional, on the other hand, are you know mostly optional. You really don't need it. So if you're just getting started, then I think required libraries is all you need. So make sure it is checked, which it is by default. Click on next, or sorry, click on finish. Okay, so here you have all those 46 libraries listed here among these categories, and you have the option of either selecting one by one and checking, accepting the license agreement, or you can just say accept all. And when you click on accept all, it straight away starts downloading. Now this will take time. It may take a couple of minutes. So I would say be patient, wait for it to download. You may need to restart Talend, but it's highly recommended that you don't do anything right now. Let it download all these libraries and install them. And you can watch the progress here. Right now it's at 13%. All right, so I'm going to skip over this video to a part where when this is complete. Okay, so the libraries are downloaded and installed. It took a couple of minutes. Now I just want to make sure that the Talend is installed correctly and everything's working fine. So for that, let me just run this demo job. So to run this job, just click on the play button here, which says run. Again, anytime you build a new job and execute it, the first time it takes a couple of minutes. So you can see that the job execution results are here. So all it's doing is it's generating some random data and just putting that in a log. But the exit code is equal to 0, which means the workflow ran fine. Right. So with this, I conclude the installation of Talend. Look at my other videos in this playlist to see how to start using Talend for some very specific purpose, as well as I'll also explore all the different components that are available within Talend. All right, thank you.